that we earn during the course of our service from the men and the leadership that the officers provide, they are prepared to go to any extent, even to the thing of laying their own life. And army is all about that. And that is what you saw here. A soldier doesn't hesitate to undertake any operation or any situation which comes in front of him, as long as he knows that the safety of the country is threatened. And we are prepared to die for that. My bio data was read about it. I commanded my unit, which consists of about 1,000 men, on the Siachen Glacier, which is the highest battlefield in the world. And how do you keep those men motivated who are operating at heights varying from 19,000 to 23,000 feet? You don't see anything other than white. White color is the only thing you see. So that is where the soldiers are operating. And we are grateful that you acknowledge that. And the song that they were singing of the letters coming, you cannot imagine. You know, the present day age of you all is an age of technology, where you do not wait for that piece of paper coming to you. You have WhatsApp, you have emails, you have various facilities available to you. But in those days, this piece of paper from back home meant everything to a soldier, or means everything to a soldier. So one has, as a soldier, what I would like to tell you all, you are young, bubbling youngsters who have taken upon a stream that you want to join. Now, you have, I suppose, when you joined this institute, you joined this institute with a dream in your mind. A person or an individual who does not have a dream in his mind and does not know where does he want to reach one day, what does he want to achieve, you will only expect a failure. You have to dream, you have to set an objective for yourself, you have to set a goal for yourself and go for it. And I can tell you, success will always be there. Second, there is nothing you can achieve in life unless you work hard. Hard work, hard work, hard work, hard work is the story of success. And I can tell you, standing here, you may say that I'm talking like this, but one has gone through these large number of years in the army, and I tell you, I stand here because of that hard work that one has put in from the time one joined the service to this rank that the army or the organization has given it. Second is the hard work. Third, the bedrock of the army is discipline. More than discipline is self-discipline. I don't look at others. I look upon myself as an individual in the army, that when no one is watching me, I should do the right thing. That is self-discipline. So army stands on this pillar of discipline. That is why it is obedience of orders. If I tell my men that, look, we've all got to go there now, on top of that hill, and I am with you, and I am in front of you, they will follow me without even blinking. So that's the discipline or the bedrock that we work on. Next thing I want to tell you all is character. I, as an individual, or I in this organization, believe that character is the most important aspect of an individual. And by character, what I mean is that we as an individual, you as a young boy or girl, stand up for what is right. Character means you do not do anything wrong which you believe will harm your beliefs. That is character. Character is that you have the willpower to execute what you want to execute. That is character. That is another issue that I want to leave with you all. Next is the power of commitment. Now anyone would say, yes, we are committed, there is a commitment in me, but I believe in that every individual has to have a channel of his life on his own. The others will be your support bases. If you are in this institute today, your faculty is your support base. Your management is your support base. But the commitment is you, you as an individual. So have that power of commitment to work and execute the task that you want to do. We are grateful to you all. I am, as an individual, very grateful to you all that you think so high of the army, you think so high of the forces. That is what takes us or moves us and keeps us going. We are prepared at any point of time. All these actions that you were showing here with terrorists, one has had a number of them. God has been kind that I'm standing in front of you. I also have a family. I can tell you all the sacrifices that a soldier has to make. I do not know that any child sitting here would have stayed away from his parents for about 12 to 15 years. I don't think anyone. My children have stayed away. Because I was roaming around in all possible field areas along the border during my career. And I did not want to disturb their education or moving them anywhere. So I kept them in a place. So the children, army children, also go through a lot of... So that is what you as children have to understand. And I would like to, and I hope some of you at least, are motivated seeing us here today to join the army. There are a lot of opportunities. Army is a very, very good organization, let me tell you. The best organization that anyone can provide you. If in my next life, if it is there and someone asks me anything, I'll say I'll don this uniform again. It's an excellent organization. It provides you adventure. It provides you anything that you can even dream of. And it pays you also reasonably well, let me tell you all. So, you are being technical graduates of mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, information technology. You have avenues to join the army after you finish your curriculum here as technical graduates. And I hope some of you amongst you are motivated today and would join us in this uniform that I stand in front of you. In the end, I wish to thank the management. Thank you all for getting us here, making me as a chief guest for this function today. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.